The Philippines is currently experiencing a power crisis with its thinning power supply. Energy Secretary Rafael Utilla called the red and yellow alerts plaguing the country's power grids a calamity. The Energy Department warns consumers rising temperatures may continue to affect power plants until after the expected peak of summer in mid-May.
We really have to work on reducing our consumption and avoiding particularly unnecessary power consumption during the peak hours. So if we can postpone, as we have done in the past, certain high power consuming activities during the off-peak hours, that would be a big help.
Lotilla says measures are being undertaken to conserve power, such as reduced working hours. Energy officials also assuring additional capacities are expected to be added to local grids this year.
More than 4,000 megawatts will come online this 2024, and it will actually help our grid. To date, 161.2 megawatts of the 2024 committed projects are in full commercial operation, while 835 megawatts are under test and commissioning. So even though they're test and commissioning, they are injecting power to the grid. Of the expected capacities, 4,030 megawatts are in Luzon, 80.25 megawatts are in Visayas, and 52.5 megawatts are in Mindanao. In terms of timeline, 1,224 megawatts will operate in the second quarter, 1,352 megawatts third quarter, and 1,571 megawatts in the fourth quarter.
A new study by the International Labor Organization found over 2.4 billion workers across the world are likely to be exposed to excessive heat. The ILO says this leaves workers vulnerable to developing several diseases such as skin cancer and respiratory illnesses.
It's critical that risk and hazard assessments be taken seriously at the enterprise level. So it's not just, it shouldn't just stop at paper compliance. It's required under the current laws. But what's important is that it's taken seriously by employers and workers within the enterprise as part of business risk mitigation measures.
A new survey shows there's no significant improvement in the number of self-rated poor Filipino families in the first quarter. The Social Weather Station's poll of some 1,500 adult respondents showed 46% consider themselves as poor. The SWS said this hardly changed from the 47% recorded in December. The pollster estimates this is equivalent to 12.9 million families from the 13 million at the end of 2023. It notes those who consider themselves food poor are up at 33% in Metro Manila and in the Visayas. The SWS survey ran from March 21 to 25. The country's inflation rate in that month climbed to 3.7% on higher food prices and transportation costs.